Me and Uncle Mo are so similar. Me and Uncle Mo are so similar. The way Uncle Mo broke down why Ronaldo is the best is literally word for word what I've been trying to say to people. He said it. Because he recognized how Messi and Cristiano have had longer careers, have been much more consistent. But he said, in terms of talent and skill set, the ability of a player using the eye test, his best player that he's ever seen. He's the best player he's ever seen. And I think whenever we have these debates and we have these back and forths, I see like there is a certain issue that caused the disconnect with the kind of debates we have with regards to the greatest player. Because I think for people who look at Messi and Cristiano, they're looking at, look at how consistent they've been, look at how much they've been able to be doing these crazy things for such a long period of time. So therefore, that makes them greater because they've been at a high level for such a long period of time. But where I'm looking at it is that I'm not looking at your consistency over years. I'm like, how great were you at your very best? How good were you at your very best? Because at your very peak, that is where I will now judge you. So that's the disconnect. Do you want to view things based on the length at which you did it? Or do you want to look at things based on when you did it, when you were at your best? There is the right answer. I prefer when you're at your best. People can prefer you being consistent. There isn't a right answer because I can't now come and say that, oh no, how good were you when you were at your best is a far better determiner than how consistent you were over 10, 15 years and vice versa. But my thing though is this, is that, and again, it's a point that Mourinho brought up. If Ronaldo didn't get that major injury, I don't think there would have been a debate. I don't think there would not have been a debate. He was too good. And what I always say to people is that pick the best attributes of your GOAT. Ronaldo had it plus plus more. So Ronaldo had Messi's dribbling, technical ability, balance on the ball. Ronaldo had Cristiano's goal scoring, strength, and speed. So just think about it. This dude was strong. This dude was fast. This dude was technically skilled. This good dude could dribble. He could also pass and provide as well. He had an incredible footballing IQ, incredible footballing brain. It was ridiculous. It was ridiculous what this guy could do. And also, people forget that he revolutionized the position. He revolutionized the position. Before Ronaldo, strikers were just finishers. That's it. Like, so if you were growing up as a striker, if you were in your school team or your youth team or so forth, in your mind it's like, I'm just here to finish. Give me the ball, let me run from the ball and let me finish. But then when people then viewed Ronaldo, they were like, oh my God, I can actually be more than just a finisher. Same thing as to what Beckenbauer did for central defenders. Before Beckenbauer, all defenders did was just like tackle, hoof the ball off. But when people saw Beckenbauer, was like, oh no, defenders can actually play on the ball. We can actually be footballers as well. So when Ronaldo came, you're like, it was the first time you saw a striker who could dribble, who was good on the ball, who could provide things. So really, Ronaldo was the precursor for the false nine. So whether you want to bring in a Lewandowski, a Firmino, a Messi, or so forth, they all how they interpret that striking false nine position to what Ronaldo did because he changed the way strikers interpreted that role and that position. But I just think it's just one of those things of where it might be an age thing as well. There are people who, like, let's say 60 and above, who say, sorry, Pele is the best player that I've ever seen. And the thing about the Pele thing is, we don't have the footage. These are people who saw this guy for real and they said, now, this is the best player that I've ever seen. You know, this guy is doing things that we've never seen before. So, but yeah, look, at the end of the day, guys, it's like, you know, I can only just go based on what I have seen. And what I've seen, as I told you, like even when I was in one of my job interviews years back, and I said, okay, name one of your heroes, and I named Ronaldo as one of my heroes because I said, just watching him as a young child, like it was literally like watching like a heroic figure, like some kind of a godlike figure, because I was like, wow, this guy is just doing something that is sort of like transcending human ability. And that sort of like inspired me as a child, just seeing it. It was like looking at a superhero. It was like looking at what he was doing. It was looking like a superhero and just rushing back home on Sunday to watch those Inter Milan games, I was like, man, let's see what Ronaldo will do. And looking at the fear of defenders whenever he had the ball, it was like watching a superhero. So that's it. Remember, guys, like the vid, share the vid, and remember to subscribe if you are new to the Half of Football Hut. This is always the daily content for footballing news and footballing content. Peace out.